Unfortunately, most Revit models have warnings, affecting not only the quality of the models, but also overall Revit performance. In this video, I'm going to explain tools to work with warnings in Revit. So let's jump into Revit. The first thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna look for a view that contains as many elements of the model as possible. Preferably a 3D view like this one. So then I'm gonna go into NonicaTab Pro and I'm gonna look for isolate warnings in selected view. Basically this bottom isolates all the elements that has a warning in the selected view. So I can either select a view from the drop-down menu or just leave it empty to use the current view. So I'm gonna leave it empty in this case and run it like that. Then we see that 74 elements out of 115 were isolated in this view. So I'm going to first focus on those 74 elements, and then I'm going to show you how to work on the rest of the elements. So let's close this and let's close this as well. Great. So all these elements that we see in the screen have a warning. So how can we have more information about them? Basically, we can just click on them and then let's close this and then go for show related warnings. This is going to show the message that is related to that specific element, the warning that is specific for this element. And also it's going to highlight, well, both elements in this case, if there are two. In this case, we see that, well, there are two walls that are overlapping. Yeah, I should actually work in the joint if I want to resolve this warning. This is only one example, but as you see, there are other type of warnings. We can just click on them and then work on them to resolve them. Great. So this is one way to isolate them. But let's imagine I want to focus on, for example, critical warnings first. So we're gonna reset the isolation, and I'm going to show you how to isolate warnings by type. So we can just use isolate warnings by type from NonicaTab Pro. When you click here, you have a list of all the warnings messages that has the model. So if I, for example, click the, let's look for highlighted walls overlap, the one that we saw before. If I click that one, it's gonna show me all the elements that have that specific warning. So I'm gonna click on those two and then isolate check. And as we see that now we're seeing 28 elements out of 29 that are basically walls that are overlapping to each other. So I can actually focus on those types, either if I want to delete them, if I want to work on the joints. So that's really up to me. Great, that's great. So let's imagine there are some elements that are not shown in the view. So this happens sometimes, and what I recommend you to actually find those elements if they're not shown in the views is to use Revit default warning tool. So we come into manage again and then inquiry. I'm gonna first reset the temporary view and then let's go into inquiry. Here, basically, after we have resolved all the, let's say, warnings that we wanted, we can see if there are any of them that are really important for our model. So for example, if there is like a wall and room separation line that is overlapping, we could just click on that one because, for example, that one won't be visible in a 3D view, and then click on show. And then basically Revit is gonna look for a view in which that specific element is shown. So I can actually get the elements highlighted and I can work on them straight away. So as you see, this is a quite fast and helpful way to actually manage your warnings. Like some of the tools that I saw, like isolate by type or isolating selected views, are really there to help you with that. So feel free to check them out in NonicaTab Pro. And I hope you find it helpful. Thank you very much. Bye-bye.